Jhelum was overflowing. Early morning on 8th of September 2014, the flood engulfed the whole Srinagar. And there was hue and cry everywhere because everybody was taken by surprise.
In the heart of Kashmir, the year 2014 brought a terrifying catastrophe as the clouds unleashed their fury, flooding the valley with relentless rains. The river Jhelum, which is a source of numerous livelihoods, was flowing ferociously after heavy and continuous rains lashed the region from 3rd September to 7th September. Sonwar, Shivpura, Patwara, and even the city center Lal Chowk was submerged after the river overspilled. The streets of Srinagar, once bustling with life, turned into rivers, and the homes that had stood for generations were submerged underwater.
The High Court was underwater for about 8 feet. The record was damaged. Chief Justice House was also underwater from 7 to 8 feet. I can't forget the early morning of 7th of September. When I finished the court on 7th, I passed through the two bridges and I found that Jhelum was overflowing. I had some guests in the house. They left at about 6 to take the flight to Delhi. On the way, I was told that even their Innova car could not wade through the flood and they had to change to some bigger vehicle.
Fear gripped the residents who initially sought refuge in high-rise buildings and eventually had to be rescued in makeshift boats as the waters continued to rise, swallowing everything in their path. At many places in the city, the flood water was about 18 feet deep, submerging entire houses and shops. Experts say that the 2014 flood was more devastating as compared to other floods in recent times because the government was not ready for such a devastation.
पूरी एक दिहाई गुजर चुकी है, मुझे आज भी वो दिन बहुत ही अच्छी तरह याद है। 7 सितंबर 2014 सुबह का वक़्त था। बेबस इतने हो गए कि हमें लगा कि ये आखिरी दिन होगा हमारी पूरे ख़ानदान का, पूरे कश्मीर का। उस दिन तक, खासकर मैं बहसत एक ट्रेडर कहना चाहता हूँ, बचपन से जो भी कमाया था, जो भी हमने तिजारत से कमाया था, अपने बाकी वसाइल से कमाया था, वो आज ख़त्म हो गया। अल्लाह करे वो दिन हमें दोबारा नसीब ना हो। बहुत ही अफसोस के साथ ये कहना पड़ता है कि तब से आज तक जो तिजारत की ये ट्रेन जो उस पटरी से उतर गई, लेकिन हमारी कोशिश आज भी यही है कि ये उस पटरी पे वापस आ जाए। उसमें अहम रोल हमारी गवर्नमेंट, वक्त की गवर्नमेंट कर सकती है।
Amidst this chaos, a beacon of hope emerged from an unlikely place, the J&K High Court. The then Chief Justice, M.M. Kumar, rose to the occasion as a savior for the devastated people of Kashmir. In a landmark judgment, he ordered insurance companies to provide interim relief to those whose homes and businesses had been insured, offering a lifeline to many who had lost everything. Faiz Bakshi of KCCI, Kashmir's premier trade body, said that the landmark judgment helped people to rebuild their lives.
Some people from Confederation of Indian Industry, Kashmir Confederation of Indian Industry came. He requested that people are suffering, there are insurance cases. I said, you have mentioned it in the court. You kindly file petition. Any help required, our staff is there to help you. Then petition were filed. About 30 petitions were filed, I think, if I remember correctly. The insurance companies, according to law, were right in arguing that unless there is a survey conducted and a report by a surveyor is submitted, they will not be able to assess the loss and they will not be able to pay. And since number of cases were many, they thought it will take at least 2 years. So I told them that 2 years is a very long period. By that time, the necessity of having insurance, that very purpose will be defeated. People are suffering right now. Because I had the reports from Polo View, from Lal Chowk, all over the areas, that they were in deep problems. So I decided that, division bench decided that, no, we must direct the insurance company that during the pendency of the petition and during the pendency of the surveyor report, you disburse at least 50% of the insured amount.
This decision was not just a legal mandate. It was a crucial step towards rebuilding lives and restoring hope in a region that had been brought to its knees by nature's wrath.
पैंतालीस सौ से 5,000 करोड़ के बीच में फिर यहाँ के जो अफेक्टेड थे, इंश्योर्ड थे, बिजनेसमैन थे, ट्रेडर्स थे, ट्रांसपोर्ट, उनको वो रिलीफ मिला बाय वे ऑफ जो उनके क्लेम्स थे। तो ये चैम्बर ऑफ कॉमर्स का उस टाइम था, बहुत बड़ा कदम था। ये अनइमेजिनेबल है और आज के 10 साल हुए हैं, 10 साल होने को है, और अगर आप वो कहानियाँ बताएँ किस तरह गाड़ियाँ भी बह गई हमारी खुद की, मैं भी मकान में था जहाँ 17 फुट पानी था, हम निकले बोटों वगैरह में, निकले सारे ऑफिस वगैरह निकले सारे, हमने कैंप लगाया बाद में और हम जो अपील करी लोगों को आप आ जाए, अपने क्लेम्स आप रजिस्टर कर लीजिए और ताकि हम वो हाई कोर्ट में आगे पेश कर लें। इट वाज ह्यूज चैलेंज दैट टाइम।
When the judgment was delivered, there was naturally some criticism because it was deviating from the well-settled law. And according to well-settled law, no direction, no insurance amount can be given unless there is a report by the surveyor certifying that this much loss has been suffered and this much deserved to be disbursed. I said that extraordinary situation need extraordinary remedies and solutions. So the checks started pouring in and I could see the sigh of relief on the faces of various people when they were given the checks. Even many lawyers, their houses were underwater, they got the checks. So I felt happy that at least they have some interim relief, they can be rehabilitated, their commercial and their shops can be replenished, they can repair it.
Justice Kumar ka jo decision tha, wahi to saving to wahi tha, usi se sara to relief to usi se mila, jo insurance ka jo claims mili 4,500 से 5,000 करोड़ तक, तो उसी decision से मिले, जो उनका एक्टिव रोल था उसी वजह से सारा हो गया।
10 years later, have we learned any lessons? Well, most of us would reply in the negative. Unplanned urbanization and encroachment of wetlands continues unabated, and desilting of water bodies no longer seems to be a priority.